ground your hips. Yeah. So check if you can feel like that you are in your sit bones, even if we are not forcing the expansion yet. Well, we never force, but that you feel nice and connected. Try to feel at least already your sit bones on the mat. Yeah. And then check if you need, or if you have the block, Vanessa. And if you need, you can put support beneath your thighs or move the legs whenever you need it, yeah? Now, like the weather is still cloudy and raining, we will focus on that light of the clouds. So even if it could be a little bit gray, you can see the white aspect of the clouds, yeah? If you have a window close, close by. So we will call that white light, that is the cleansing light, is a purifying light. Plus, you can imagine the rain or the water on the clouds if it's not raining there yet. Well, here it's not raining yet. Imagine also that quality of the water washing over you. And so we use those two aspects, yeah, to start to bring the energy from above. Just checking. And then start to focus on your breathing. So when you breathe in, just let the imagination go into this idea of being surrounded by this white light, or the idea that you are starting to receive like a magical shower with that rain, yeah, with that water, pure over your head, your neck, your shoulders, and imagine all that combination of light and the image of the pure water wash over your body. But also imagine that you breathe in that light inside, and so that washing, that cleansing is coming also inside your body. And you can even direct that energy to those spots that maybe you need the most today, or just leave it run freely through your body, and the energy will know where it has to go. Yeah? And as you breathe out, yeah, you connect more to the floor, start to visualize your roots. Here is depending how you feel more comfortable. If you prefer to visualize your roots coming from your body into the floor every time, or you can imagine, if you always do the class in the same spot or in the same room, you can imagine just plugging yourself. So like you don't have to do an effort. The roots are ready there. Yeah? And you plug, you connect like a more deeply. You never lose a connection. Imagine that you just are more aware of that connection. And remind yourself that those roots are touching the center of the planet, that core of steel or iron that is giving you that sense of stillness and stability, strength, resilience, okay, being deeply grounded and deeply strong. And also you start to receive all the nourishment that the planet has in every aspect. Yeah? So through the roots, and as you breathe in, you're receiving that nourishment. And on the breathe out, you keep grounding more, connecting more, and releasing the old energy, the used energy that you have in the body, the tension, the stress, to be recycled. Okay? So when you have that in place, those images and the ideas, just let it there. And then you just relax. We put the hands on the floor and we soften. Okay? Just the idea that once you call the energies to do that work, they are working there and you don't have to worry anymore. Yeah? Just you only worry in bracket is just to relax and connect and move with the flow, with the breathing. So let go completely. Remember, not force. Relax your neck, your head, your shoulder blades. And then we move the hands to one side. And then to the other side. And then to the center, coming back. We put the hands behind, grounding your hips. Open your chest, relax your shoulders away, breathing deeply. And imagine receiving that white light into your body from the from above, from the front. And as always, we can imagine that pink light that we were working the last few weeks, yeah, the loving and caring energy always there to support you as you do the openings. And then relax your chin to the chest, relax your neck. Relax, well done. We go with the other leg, yeah? So we put the other leg forward. And again, grounding your hips, we soften. Remember, if it's possible, to start the movement with your belly first, yeah? Like we do all the forward bends, so belly first, then solar plexus, and then your chest, and then your head. And allow your hands to relax, your elbows to relax, your shoulder blades, and your neck and your head. Soften, yeah? Surrender into the floor. And then we move the hands to one side. Put the hands behind, grounding your hips again, pushing into the floor with your hips to open the front of your body. Try to check that your shoulders are not tensing up, and lifting solar plexus and chest. We don't have to force the head back, yeah? Remember the neck comfortable. And just focus on the opening of your chest and your solar plexus to take the energy in. Yeah, so imagine your heart is receiving the pink light, yeah? The loving energy, and your solar plexus is receiving the energy. And then relax your chin to the chest. And relax. Good. And then we will start to move the body in circles. Using that grounding. Yeah? So the body is like a moving around to help you to ground more and to relax more your inner thighs or open more your inner thighs without forcing it. Yeah? Just let the weight of your body help you. And at the same time, keep imagining that as you do this circular movement, you are receiving, like you are focusing the energy more, yeah, like you are creating that cone or vortex to receive the energy from above and from beneath. And then working with the other side. And then on the center, lengthen your spine, yeah? Relax the shoulders away, open, and we start to rotate toward one side. So keep the hips, don't move the hips, your hips are deeply grounded, you only move the spine. Yeah? So imagine that you can even move the lower spine, so like even the sacrum and the coccyx, you can't, but imagine that you start the movement from there. And when you breathe in, you lengthen. So the twist is nice and long, and you move the vertebras between each other, trying to free the space for the discs. Yeah? So no forcing, shoulders away. Try to connect a little bit your belly. Not tensing too much that you can breathe, just tensing a little bit. Good. Now, when you are to the maximum of your twist there, try to bring the belly a little bit more in, like the lower part of your belly, and try to twist a little bit more with that support. You will notice that you can twist a little bit more. Not in a forcing way, eh? You are supporting your lower back then. And keeping the position, we bring the head to the front and then to the other side. Remember your shoulders away. And then back to the twist. And relax, release, well done. Now, on the center, again, you ground your hips, lifting, yeah, with a nice connection, but not tensing that you can breathe. Start to rotate. Lengthening, yeah? So you keep lengthening the top of your head up, lengthening the back of the neck. And when you are right to the maximum position there again, re-engage a little bit more your lower belly and check if you can twist a little bit more. You will notice that you can move a bit more without going into forcing it. And you keep the position and we bring the head to the front and to the other side. And then back to the twist and relax. Well done, very nice. So relax the shoulders and we will move a little bit the head just to have it more relaxed to do shoulders as well. So we will bring the head, so keeping the chest up, the solar plexus lifted. Yeah? We will relax the shoulders, but we keep the spine and the body nice and strong there. Yeah? And we move the head only to the side, but keep lengthening your spine and the back of the neck, yeah? And then back to the center and we go to the other side. Back to the center. Don't do it fast, eh? It is freedom. So we go to the side. Lengthen the back of the neck, even there on the side. Come back to the center. We go to the other side. So as you move, keep lengthening the spine. Keep pushing into the hips and lifting the crown of your head, lengthening the back of the neck. We do it one more time. Back to the center. We go to one side. Pushing hips, lifting the crown of your head, lengthening the back of the neck. And one more time. So when you do that lengthening, check that you can feel the lengthening or the movement on really on the muscles of the big muscle and on the side of the neck, yeah, the big chunky muscle here is called the sternocleidomastoideus. I don't know in English, but I think it's similar. That you lift in there, that you feel that lengthening on the neck. And then relax. Well done. Very nice. Now we will go to all fours, yeah? Now remember as well here, the shoulders away, yeah? And we move. I repeat this. I know that you know it by now, but the repetition that you hear it is like taladrate in your brain. So at some point it's becoming a voice in your head saying shoulder, 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 shoulder. And that helps. Yeah. So when you tense your shoulders, at some point will be a little Claudia saying, hello, your shoulders. And that will take a lot of the tension that we carry. Yeah. We go to the other side. Soft. And imagine as you move, you are allowing the tension to go out of your body on those parts, and you are allowing the new energy to come into those parts. Yeah. So we replace the stress or the tension with fresh and supple energy. We go to the center, relaxing shoulders away, open your chest. Yeah. Now relax your lower back deeply, relax your belly. Let your spine adapt to that arching position. So we are not forcing, remember, it's just let it fall naturally. And feel also the opening of the solar plexus and the belly. Yeah? So let your the weight fall there. Yeah? And then we will do the opposite, rounding through the lower back. Shoulders again are away. You round to the maximum that you can do. And remember to, okay, we were working the last couple of classes, to squeeze your lower belly. So the part, like the flesh or the fat, above the pubic bone, all that area. Yeah, from the pubic bone to the little roundy thing that you have on the belly. I can't remember the belly button. So from the pubic bone to the belly button, all that area. Pushing a little bit in when you're round. Yeah? Not tensing too much that you tense the whole of your belly and your chest, just that part. So we are working. And then relax. Yeah, we are working. When we engage that part, we are engaging also the pelvic floor. Yeah, and also the lower back as well. So squeeze that part, but the rest of your body is soft. So your shoulders and your neck are not tensing. And then relax. And one more time, squeezing from the pubic bone. Let's say all the muscles around. And then relax, yeah? We curve the toes, we arch again. And also when we do that squeezing, that you are working on the pelvic floor, you don't have to worry about the pelvic floor because it's tricky to work in the pelvic floor. But with this movement, you work it and you don't realize it. So a more benefit, yeah? So squeeze again, feel like the pubic bone engaging all that area, and relax. Soften. We do it one more time. Squeeze. Very nice. And then we go to child pose. So we open the knees. We go back. Soften shoulders. Soften head. Relax your shoulder blades. Let go completely. Check that your elbows are touching the floor, eh? So you can relax the upper body. Soften, soften shoulders away from your ears. Go. And try to keep going with your hips a little bit more back as you relax. So not forcing, but try to bring your hips back toward your feet. And then we move the hands to one side. And then to the other side. And then coming back to the center, and we go to all fours, to round and do circles with your upper back, yeah? So even if we move the whole back, your focus is on the chest and the shoulder blades. But really important to do this movement in the right place. Remember the shoulders are away from your ears when you go down and when you go up, yeah? And imagine that in that movement, again, we are getting into those areas where we hold a lot of the tension. Okay? And also in the emotional aspect, we are working the heart center. So imagine that we are releasing and dissolving the barriers, yeah, the walls that we put in our heart. And we still can be open it. Secure because we have that pink light working with us, yes, so that unlimited, unconditional loving energy to protect the heart, yeah? To open but protect it at the same time, yeah. So you let the energy fall, go to the other side. So the tension is falling, it's dissolving on the physical aspect, and on the emotional aspect, you have that protection and that feeling with the loving energy of the pink light, yeah, the heart center. Good. We will bring one arm underneath the other arm. We put the shoulder. Remember, when you put the head, expand a little bit the neck before you put the head. And then the other arm, relaxing. Check if you can release the elbow as well here. The hand that is forward, yeah? That elbow, even if you don't touch on the floor, try to relax it toward the floor so you can relax. That bring relaxation into your shoulder blade. The one that is on the up, yeah? The one that is on the floor, you just relax it and let your chest, your heart also relax on the support of your arm and the support of the floor and the planet. And again, imagine the pink light surrounding you and feeling you completely. And then we relax, we go to the other side. Soften. Relax your shoulder blades, relax your elbow. And then coming back. And we go to the center. So shoulders away, we'll start with downward facing dog. Moving the hips back. Yes, so it's like you want to bring the weight of your body away from your hands to don't put pressure on your shoulders. So we go back with your hips. You go far away with your bum. Your hips are out. Yeah? Remember, bring the hips tilting out first, and we go back, opening the chest. And then we try to work on the legs like a one by one. And then try to bring both, but don't worry if you don't touch the heels. So you go with the hips back. Open chest and relax your head, relax your heels. Now we will go forward with to plank with your elbows toward the hands. So shoulders above your hands, but your body is long, your heels are back. Your chest is open, shoulders away from your ears. And then hips out and we move back to downward facing dog. So the downward facing dog, the hips are out. We will work that standing. And when you move to plank, your hips are like a tilting forward, the opposite. Yeah? So your body is long. It's not arching, it's not grounded. And then again, out with the hips, and we go back. That movement will free a lot of the tension that we carry on the lower back. Yeah? Well done. Now we put the knees on the floor. Shoulders again away. We work with one leg. And we do the same that we did before. So when you round, when you bring your knee forward, imagine that you want to touch your head and your head want to touch your knee, but also doing that squeezing of the pubic area, pubic bone area, that little, the flesh or the fat or both that you have above the pubic bone, yeah? So when you round, you press, and when you open, relax, release, shoulders away. And again, moving forward, relaxing your neck, yeah? So there is no tension or squeezing on your shoulders. It's the lower belly, the lower back. Expand one more. In the next one, we stay forward with the knee and we keep the position, pushing with your hands against the floor, but the shoulders are away, and you push that flesh in, yeah? That lower belly in, and then relax it. We go with the other leg. So expanding open, shoulders away, and then slowly pushing in. Not that you can breathe, eh? and relax. So a balance between squeezing but keeping the control of your breath. And again. Yeah, so a few times. And in the next one, we stay forward. Squeezing, keeping the position, shoulders away. Feel your lower back, feel the engaging of the belly there. And relax. Now, we bring the leg back, yeah? Heel up, so your foot is flexed. And we lifting again the lower back here. Engaging a little bit the belly. That the action is like the lower back going up. Again, shoulders are away. Yeah, the head is long, the neck is long. Relax, we go with the other leg. So, heel, squeeze the lower back up. Your shoulders are away from your ears. It's only the lower back to create a nice straight line on your back. Yeah, relax, we do it one more time. So, heel. Lifting lower back, shoulders away. Now, if you have the left leg back, you bring your arm, your right arm forward, so the opposite arm. If you have the right leg back, you bring your left arm. And we try to balance there, lifting your lower back. Up, up, up with the lower back, more. Not the leg, the lower back. Bring the belly in, Nessa. Yes, relax. And we go with the other leg. Yeah? So, put the heel first, flex your foot. You pull with the heel, yeah? Lifting the lower back first. Yes. And now lifting the arm, opposite arm. Keep lifting the lower back up. There we are. And flex your heel as crazy. So, Susan, bring your toes down. And try to flex the foot. Relax. Relax for a moment. Relax, yeah? Just the foot, I don't know if you can see it here, the foot is flexed. Instead of pointing the toes, the foot in this position, yeah? We will do it one more time. This is really good for creating a strength on the back, yeah? So, heel, foot flex, lifting lower back, and lifting the opposite arm. Lower back up, yes. Relax, and we go with the other leg. Good. So lower back up, yes, and then lifting the arm. Stay, stay. Well done, well done. Relax, relax. Well done, well done. Very nice, very nice. So we bring one leg forward, and we will relax the hips, yeah? Soften. So shoulders away. Relax the thigh and the groin, yeah? Relax your hips. Shoulders away, we lift in the arms. Lengthening, expanding. Soften. Good. Try to lengthen up, not too much back, yeah? Shoulders are away from your ears. Beautiful, well done. And we relax, yeah? We will move again the hips out and we lean back with the hips out. We can put the hands or one in each side of the leg or one on the leg and the other one on the floor, yeah? A little bit, don't go too crazy, just to mobilize the hip and to stretch the back of the thigh there, yeah? The chest is open, remember not to round here. Well done. And we go forward, we change. And again, relax, hips, soften. So we lengthen without tensing, yeah? Lengthening and expanding, shoulders relax, hips relax. Open your chest, don't move too much back, yeah? And then we put the hands on the floor, and we put the hand or on the leg or on the other side of the leg, hips moving out. And then we go all the way up to the front, bring the back leg forward, and we go into the feet to a standing position. Good. So we start from the floor going up. Yes. So remember your feet nice and open. Imagine you are engaging with the roots. You are creating that beam or channel of energy through your feet. When you go into the legs, remember the knees are not tensing back, are soft, not bending. Yeah. Soft. Good. Well done. And then we will work a little bit on the hips, yeah? So I go a little bit close. So again, relax your hips out, yeah? And then relax your hips, bringing forward, yeah? So tilting out and tilting forward, yeah? Cool. So again, this I'm trying to get into your brain. When we do forward bends, downward facing dog, the hips are out because the position that you go in the forward bend will extend your spine. Yeah? When we go into back bends, bridges or all the poses that we open the front, the hips are tilting forward to ensure that you are protecting the lower back. Yeah? Because if you have the lower back arching and you go into back bends, you are squeezing the lower back and that creates pain. Yeah. So out and in. Yeah. And then you have neutral, normal. Yeah. So in that neutral position, we will go to expand. Yeah. And now the focus, relaxing shoulders, is like as you stretch, you are lifting the energy from the planet. And it's the energy that expands you, yeah? Instead of thinking that I have to stretch, you think, oh, I want that energy all the way into every single part of my body and yourself. And at the same time, imagine that you are reaching for the energy that is above as well, yeah? Then we will go to the side, softening the knees. Remember that softening of the knees is really important to don't put tension on the lower back, shoulders away. Check your knees often when you are standing, like if you go to the shops and we have to do queues, those moments, check that you are not tensing your knees, yeah? We go to the other side. Don't fall, yeah? Expand, but without tensing. The middle way there. And then up again, shoulders away. We will go forward. We will round now your back. But still the shoulders are away from your ears. Pushing everything in, yeah? We can move a little side to side. Good. And then expanding, pushing into the feet, shoulders away. And rotating the shoulders back. We catch the hands and we expand. Yeah? Now the hips are tilting forward. And lifting the solar plexus and the chest without hanging into the lower back. Yeah? One more time. And then relax. Well done. Very nice. So before we go to sun salutation, we will do a little bit of grounding. More now that things are starting to open to be nice and connected when we go out. Yeah? So move your body. Again, with that idea that the feet are connected with the roots, that you are not finishing on the mat, yeah, that the roots are part of your body. Move your body side to side. The knees are soft, yeah, so you don't have to tense your body because you have the support of the floor, yeah? So when you go now to one of the legs, we engage up, but without tensing your leg or tensing your body. It's just this transfer of energy goes up, okay? And you go with the toes on the floor or your foot on your calf or on your knee or on your inner thigh. So the curve of your foot, yeah, the arch of your foot, you put it on the curvy part of your leg, wherever that is, on your foot, on your calf, where it's roundy, you put your arch. That gives you more balance, yeah? And then just keep lengthening, keep feeling the same idea that you push into the floor to receive that energy up, and you can put your hands or on your chest or on your belly or in prayer position or going up. That's leave it to yourself, to what is coming. Sometimes you want to be there with you, like a more intimate, more secure, and sometimes you want to expand. Yeah. So let it to your feeling. Yeah. Don't worry if you move. Eh? The practice is that centering all the time. We are not perfect that we are always still. Yeah. And then relax. And we go to the center and then come back to the other leg. So again, when you transfer to the side, you lengthen that same space that you transfer, you put it up. You are connecting with the root. Your knees soft. We put the toes or the calf or your knee or above. Okay? And then again, you go wherever is the feeling. Yeah. And don't worry if you fall and come back. This is like a metaphor of our life. So we are not all the time still and like a grounded and in a good place. Yeah. We are moving through life like this. So this is like that. Yeah. Knowing that we only need to find our center in any situation. Yeah. Cool. And then relax. We soften. Cool. So we go to the Zoom salutation, trying to keep the sensation of being grounded all the time through the different movements. Yeah, so we will go to the top of your mat and breathing, expanding, open, open chest, solar plexus, and then expand, hips out, belly, chest, and we relax, we soften. Letting go, hands, head, and neck. Then we put the hands on your floor, on the shins. We look up. So your bum is still out. Your body is open. Your chest is open. Hands on the floor. We go to plank. Now in your plank, the hips are tilting a little bit forward. Remember that action. Put your knees on the floor. Here you decide if we go to all fours or you want to go to upward facing dog. If you go, you keep, when you go to the arching position, you keep your hips tilting forward. So you go slowly forward and then your hips are tilting forward and your belly is in. It's the same position. So you don't relax the belly into the floor. You don't fall into the floor. You are on your arms. That's protect your lower back. And the upper body, the neck is long. It's not forcing up. Yeah. We go up to downward facing dog. And now the opposite. Hips are out for the downward facing dog. Open chest. Relax your head and open. Good. Try to stay in the downward facing dog a little bit. Going back with your hips, open your belly toward the legs, your solar plexus toward the legs, your head relaxing. Now we bring the right leg forward toward the hands directly, or we can put always remember the knees first and then your leg. We expand, yeah? Soften. Warrior two, relaxing the hips, relaxing the shoulders. Now check again, as always, the position of the foot, the arch, that you don't allow the arch to flatten there because that brings the knee. So your foot is nice and connected, your knee is on the center. Good. We put the arm on the front leg, we work a little bit on the shoulders now. We open hip, belly, chest, shoulder, neck, bring the arm up, check that your shoulders are away from your ears, and we will do a circle with your arm. When you pass up, checking that the shoulder didn't go here. So you keep this space as you move the arm all the time, soft. It's not tensing, yeah? Very nice. Good. So Nessa, try to do it the opposite way. Try to start Yes, there you are. Just to help the shoulder. It's nothing wrong to do it on the other side, just for the position of the shoulder. Now, bring it back. Put it behind your back now. And rotate a little bit more this part. The chest and the shoulder and this space. And stay a little bit there. Yes, beautiful, well done. One more time. And then keeping this opening, try not to move this. Just position the arm in that spot, keeping the shoulders. And keeping the shoulder, move the hand forward without moving the shoulder. And I try to feel your back heel, the back leg, the heel pushing into the floor and your fingers far away without tensing, yeah? Just with the same idea that you use the grounding to spread your body, just to feel the energy, not to spending the energy, yeah? Coming back, we put the hand, hip or lower leg, back leg, we open the front, shoulders away, and we relax the hips. Now, when you do that, remember again the knee, yeah? Spread, hips, relax, open solar plexus, open chest, but without arching too much on the lower back. Soften shoulder. Coming back, relax the shoulders, belly in. Control, we go back to plank. Shoulders away. So the plank, remember hips are tilting forward. Put your knees, relax the bum now. So we do like a little relaxing on the hips. And then when you go forward, you bring again the hips tilting forward. Your chest is open. The back of the neck is long. Your shoulders are away. We go up, hips out and back. Out and back. And then you let the upper body follow your hips back. Yes, so your body is going toward the legs. Relax your shoulder blades. Relax your head, your neck. Relax your heels. We bring the left leg forward. Warrior two again. So again, relax your hips, relax your shoulders, and check the front knee in line. Here, not to the center. If you notice the knee going to the center, it's because of the arch of your foot. Yeah? Well done. We ground the front arm. Open. Hip, belly, chest, neck, and we lift in the arm. When you lift in the arm again, the shoulders are away. And then start the circle, keeping this space back. Soften the shoulder, yeah? Check that you are not tensing the shoulder blade. Yes, open chest. Very nice. Soft, eh? Soft, soft, soft. And then we put the arm behind your back and then rotate the shoulder. Good. Very nice, huh? I lost you for a moment there, Susan. Open chest, open a little bit your neck as well. Yeah, nice and open, beautiful. Now, bring the arm up without losing that position of the shoulder and then go forward with your arm without tensing and try to feel that connection with the heel and that lengthening into your fingers. Keep relaxing the hips and then pushing, connecting. We open and we soften. Good, well done. And then coming back, relaxing, squeeze, 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 back to the floor, plank, length, shoulders away, and chest and chin, and then belly in, hips forward, shoulders away, lengthen the back of the neck, and then back, hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, heels. And we bring the legs forward toward the hands. And we go all the way up, expanding. And relax. Well done. Very nice. Now, we do one more, the last one, yeah? So, breathing, expanding. Open. Breathe out, relaxing. So, hips out. Belly, solar plexus, chest, head. Go. Lengthen up. We go back to plank. Shoulders away. We go chest and chin. Expanding. Belly in. Shoulders away. And then back. Hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head. We bring the right leg forward. We will go to warrior two. Yeah. Check the knee. Yeah. So from here, we will rotate with the strength of your core to warrior one. Moving the back foot if we need, engaging, lifting your arms. Yeah. So connecting the hips, the front, shoulders are away. Yeah. Cool. So once you feel this, try to relax. Relax the hips more. Yeah, go lower. Beautiful. Very nice. Stay there, okay? Now from there, we will open again to warrior one. So we will move the back foot again open. We open the hips and we go to warrior two, keeping the knee open. Yeah? Soften more. Yeah? And then one more time, squeezing from here, rotate. And we go to warrior one, belly in, expand, shoulders away, lengthen, ground, 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 and open, a big circle, shoulders away. Yeah, stay one more time, a big circle, shoulders are away, soften shoulders, relax, but chest is lifted. And we put the hands on the floor and we go back to plank. And then again, chest and chin, belly in, shoulders away, open. We go up, expand, and then back, open. We bring the left leg forward. We go to warrior two. Ground. So again, check the front knee that is open, yeah? Relax, relax, soften. So starting from the center, we rotate forward, and as you rotate the hip, you rotate the foot as well to accommodate it to the space of the hip. And we open. Lengthening there, yeah? So expanding without tensing, but not hanging, because if you hang the spine on the warrior one, you force the lower back. So you relax the hips, but the spine is long without going into tension. Then we open again, open foot, open hip, relax your shoulder, a nice open warrior two. Hips are open away. And then again, from here, we rotate the hips. As you rotate the hip, you rotate the foot, expand. So it's a more open warrior one after the warrior two. That's what we do it. Lengthen, yeah? So expand there, shoulders away. A nice big circle, shoulders away. Chest is open, solar plexus is open. Relax. Again, chest. Arms, belly in. And then we put the hands on the floor, back to plank. And chest and chin. Belly in, expand, open. And then we go up. Up and back, hips out. Then relax your heels, open your chest. And then put your knees on the floor and we go to child pose, or with the arms forward or the arms beneath your forehead. Let go. And then we release and we go to hero pose. Now, again, as always, you sit or on your legs or crossing. Yeah. So in that position, we settle there. Shoulders away. Yeah. So we'll work a little bit more on the hips here, if you don't mind. So just checking. Ah, we are both on the knees, no? Yeah? Mm-hmm. Okay. Cool. So sorry, I changed my, you are in the knees, Susan?
Yeah, yes, okay. but I have a roller.
Because I do something next. So keeping that idea of the hips, okay? We press into the shins and we go up. Now, squeeze your hips tilting forward, squeezing this part, lengthen, yeah? Shoulders away. Something similar like we do when we have the chair behind, yeah? But I want this movement of the hips here, yeah? Okay, expanding, chest open, lifting chest, solar plexus, and we do the same, we're lifting the arms. Expanding, so we are not hanging on the lower back. We are lengthening this part and we're lifting the chest and the solar plexus. And then rotate the hips out and we go back. Yeah, it's just to get that movement of the hips on the different positions. So we go again, lifting as you push and you go, you bring the hips tilting forward. Your pubic bone here area is all engaged. Your lower back is long. You're lifting, we expand. Imagine that you are doing a warrior one like just we did. We are not arching back, eh? Lengthening up, and the part that you open is from the chest back, but without tensing the shoulders, yeah? And then relax your arms and bring the hips out now to go back. Yeah, we do it one more time, okay? So pushing, engaging the hips, lengthen your body, spread, take a nice deep breath, expand more without going into the lower back, it's the chest. The hands, you can be facing the ceiling there. And then relax your arms, relax your hips out to go down. Yeah? Okay, very nice. That's how after we do the camel position, but we need that nice and have the hips really oil in those positions, yeah, to be able to do that. So now we're sitting again on the feet and we work into the upper body. So keeping the chest in position, shoulders away, soften, yeah, expand. We go again up for a moment, checking the position of the shoulders, and then release. We stay on the middle. We round now, catching all the energy that you need, the pink light into your heart, the white light, the beautiful energy. We catch all that energy into ourselves. We cross. Yeah? Cool. Keep it there. So, like we did yesterday, the day before, we, instead of move the arms, we move the back. So we round the upper back. And then we go into the hips and lifting chest, your shoulders are away, yeah? So when you breathe out, you relax your back, the breathing pushing into the hips, bringing the chest over your elbows, yeah? So you go away from your arms with your back. And then you go closer with your chest. We go away with your back. We get closer with the chest one more time. Beautiful. And then we open again. We go with the other arm. So we spread. catching all that beautiful pink light, that loving energy on the heart and the rest of the beautiful energy. And we round, we catch it all, we bring it inside, we close it inside so they don't escape. And then again, breathe out, relax, shoulders away, and then into the hips, into the chest, into the arms. Away from your arms. And expanding one more time. Beautiful. And then we relax, yeah, stay. Now we will do it like we did the other day as well. We put both arms first. Yeah, with the shoulders away from your ears. So you choose one, you stay there. You choose one to stay there. You rotate in the same manner, the shoulder back and down. So this space is beautifully opening. We bring the other arm. Again, the shoulder is not tensing up. And we put the hand wherever you can. Expanding, again, solar plexus and chest, yeah? So we don't force the position, it's just the breathing, opening, shoulders away, breathe deeply, very nice. And then this arm, expand up, we put it behind, yeah? So you put it nice and back, and you do the same, rotating, putting it back, space, and then you go with the other arm, space as well, and then chuck, 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 wherever you can, so the shoulders don't go up. Yeah. And expand, breathe from the chest, from the solar plexus, the expansion, yeah? And then spread, we soften and we relax. Rotate the shoulders again and you put your hands or on your thighs or on the floor. But if you can put it on the thighs so the shoulders can keep rotated back. And just breathe for a moment. Good. Well done. So from here we will expand again. You can stretch your legs or in downward facing dog or legs forward, and we will lie down on the back, yeah? With your knees bending. So we will go to like a bridge. Before you go, so you can watch just for a moment, yeah? When we are lying down, we will work in the same movement of the hips. So when we go to the bridge, we will do this action. We will bring the hips tilting forward. So we will start the bridge with the lower back really connected on the floor. And when we go up, we go with the hips in this position. Yes, so really doing this action of tilting forward. And on the bridge, we will be in this position. Okay? So lying down. Knees forward. Up. Sorry, moving my mic. Go, well done. Go, so. Take your time there and spread your back, spread your arms. You have your shoulder blades nice and open now because we did the pose before. So spread your shoulder blades, expand the back of your neck, relax your back, relax your lower back. Oh, stay for a moment there, feeling your back on the floor. So check all the points of your back. If you are touching, yeah? And then do that tilting forward of the hips, yes? Yeah? So you bring the hips tilting forward, your lower back is more connecting now, and you feel like the lower belly a little bit more engaged. You are not tensing your belly. You want the belly soft to breathe, but the lower belly is a little bit engaged for the position of the hips. And with this position, we go up. So you press into the floor with your feet, you lifting your thighs, your groins are up, your hips are tilting forward still, your belly is in. You go into the back of the neck and you spread. And keep the hips in that position, yeah? Keep going. Yes, very nice. Belly in, the lower belly. Yeah? Yes, beautiful. And then slowly relax, 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 relax. Very nice. Well done. Bring your knees to the chest. Good. And in the next, we will do one more, one bridge more, okay? In the next bridge, when we are up, we will try to, we will go again with the hips tilting forward. But when we are up on the bridge, we will try to do the movement of the hips. So we will try to, on the bridge, eh? Once we are up, we will try to move the hips out and then the hips forward. The hips out and the hip forward on the bridge. Once we are up, we try one or two times, yeah? So we go again to the bridge, put your feet, tilting the hips forward to start. We go up. Very nice. Well done. Now, once you are in your higher position, again, try to relax your hips out. Check if you can, like arching your lower back. And then up again, hip forward. Yes. Hips out. Yes. Hips up. One more time, hips out, arching the lower back, yes, and then up. Well done. And then relax. Beautiful, ladies, well done, well done. Relax, and we bring the knees to the belly. That is a beautiful, just when we get, starting to get where you have your hips in each movement, it's more easy to release the tension of the lower back, because you know when you are tensing, when you are not. Yeah, you are in control. You are aware of what is happening there. Yeah. So we bring the knees forward toward the belly. Mm-hmm. And roll. Now relax, relax. Relax your back, your lower back, your shoulders. And then we soften the knees toward one side. We open the arms, relaxing shoulders away. And just relaxing your spinal twist. Now just open to keep receiving those energies, yeah? The loving energy, the pink light, the white light that is still there, or the image of the rain, like a magical water, magical rain washing over you. And from beneath, you have that strength, resilience, stillness of the planet, plus all the resources, all the nutrition, all the nourishment that you can imagine the planet has. You are absorbing that easily into yourself, into your body. And then slowly, slowly, we go to the other side. And we soften. And then coming up, if you like, we can do a little bit of happy baby pose, yeah, to relax even deeper. So bending the legs, try to put the shoulder blades on the floor and the head is still on the floor, so you can catch your thighs or your shins or calf or your toes, but not forcing, okay? So wherever you arrive, to keep the head and the shoulder blades on the floor and soften there. And then we go to Shavasana. Yeah? So nice and flat. You put your blanket if you want. You can put a pillow beneath your knees. Yeah. And we soften there. So again, once you are in the position, visualize all those wonderful energies there. the ones from the planet, the ones from above. And then imagine that we combine those energies. We create like a huge combined energy beam or light of energy. And those energies, that combination is going into your feet. Yeah? So imagine open the sole of your feet to receive this energy. And this energy has the power to cleanse everything that has to be cleansed or dissolved, giving you more freedom, more space, more relaxation, more peace, more comfort. So imagine that energy on the sole of your feet, on your heels, on your ankles, on the top of your foot, your toes. And then imagine it's going into your lower legs, your knees, your thighs and your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back. And then from there, it's going into your arms, hands and fingers. And then imagine going into your wrists, elbows, shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly. Allowing your body to surrender completely to the floor. And going deeply inside now. And relax. 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 Slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to get back to your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet, moving your fingers, your toes, moving your head side to side. And bringing your arms back and lengthen and stretch. And from there, we go to one side Bending your knees to a sitting position. Crossing your legs. And if you like, you can place your hands or on your heart or on your belly or one and one. And just imagine that you are absorbing and you are reassuring yourself that you have those energies and this feeling still with you. And that feeling and those energies will remain with you through your day. They are not finishing acting because you finish your class. Yeah? The energy is still there with you, there at your home and wherever you go. And if you have doubts, you can always use that gesture of the hands into your body, yeah? Just to feel again this feeling. And with practice, you will feel that that power is on your hands as well. So just the action of focusing on the breathing and touching your heart or your belly will give you the same feeling. Yeah? So give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to join this class. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me. Thank you.